Glory to our God, glory to you, Heavenly King, Comforter, Spirit of Truth, everywhere present and filling all things, Treasury of blessings and Giver of life. Come and abide in us and cleanse us from every stain and save our souls, O good one.
Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, forgive us our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever into the ages of ages.
Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Come, let us worship and bow down before God, our King. Come, let us worship and bow down before Christ, God, our King. Come, let us worship and bow down before him, Christ, our King and God. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great mercy, and according to the abundance of your compassion, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from my lawlessness, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my lawlessness and my sin is always before me. Against you only have I sinned and done evil in your sight, that you may be justified in your words and overcome when you are judged. For behold, I was conceived in transgressions, and in sins my mother bore me. Behold, you love truth. You showed me the unknown and secret things of your wisdom. You shall sprinkle me with hyssop, and I will be cleansed. You shall wash me, and I will be made whiter than snow. You shall make me hear joy and gladness. My bones that were humbled shall greatly rejoice. Turn your face from my sins and blot out all my transgressions. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me with your guiding spirit. I will teach transgressors your ways, and the ungodly shall turn back to you. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall greatly rejoice in your righteousness. O Lord, you shall open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. For if you desired sacrifice, I would give it. You will not be pleased with whole burnt offerings. A sacrifice to God is a broken spirit. A broken and humbled heart God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in your good pleasure to Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built. Then you will be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with offerings and whole burnt offerings. Then shall they offer young bulls upon your altar.
O God, give heed to help me. O Lord, make haste to help me. May those who seek my soul be dishonored and shamed. May those who plot evils against me be turned back and disgraced. May those be turned back immediately who shame me, saying, well done, well done. May all who seek you greatly rejoice and be glad in you. And let those who love your salvation always say, let God be magnified. But I am poor and needy, O God, help me. You are my helper and deliverer, O Lord, do not delay. O Lord, hear my prayer, give ear to my supplication in your truth. Answer me in your righteousness. Do not enter into judgment with your servant, for no one living shall become righteous in your sight. For the enemy persecuted my soul, he humbled my life to the ground. He caused me to dwell in dark places as one long dead, and my spirit was in anguish within me. My heart was troubled within me. I remembered the days of old. I meditated on all your works. I meditated on the works of your hands. I spread out my hands to you. My soul thirsts for you like a waterless land. Hear me speedily, O Lord. My spirit faints within me. Turn not your face from me, lest I become like those who go down into the pit. Cause me to hear your mercy in the morning, for I hope in you. Make me know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk, for I lift up my soul to you. Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord, for to you I flee for refuge. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. Your good spirit shall guide me in the land of uprightness. For your name's sake, O Lord, give me life. In your righteousness you shall bring my soul out of affliction. In your mercy you shall destroy my enemies. You shall utterly destroy all who afflict my soul, for I am your servant.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill to men. We praise you, we bless you, we worship you, we glorify you, and we thank you for your great glory. Lord King, heavenly God, Father Almighty, only begotten Son, Lord Jesus Christ and Holy Spirit, Lord God, the Lamb of God, the Son of the Father, who take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us, you who take away the sins of the world. Accept our supplication, you who sit at the right of the Father, and have mercy on us. For you are the only Holy One, you are the only Lord, Jesus Christ, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Every evening I shall bless you, and I shall praise your name forever and unto the ages of ages. Lord, you have become for us a refuge from generation to generation. I have said, Lord, have mercy on me. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. Lord, to you have I fled. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. For with you is the fountain of life. In your light we shall see light. Extend your mercy to those who know you. Grant, O Lord, that in this night we may be kept without sin. Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, and praised and glorified is your name unto the ages. Amen. Let your mercy, Lord, come upon us just as we have hoped in you. Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your commandments. Blessed are you, O Master, make me understand your commandments. Blessed are you, O Holy One, enlighten me with your commandments. Lord, your mercy remains forever. Do not turn away from the works of your hands. To you belongs praise, to you belongs a hymn, to you belongs glory. To the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate and suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day according to the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke to the prophets. In one holy Catholic and apostolic church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen. It is truly right to bless you, Theotokos, ever blessed, most pure and mother of our God, more honorable than the cherubim and more beyond compare, more glorious than the seraphim. Without corruption, you gave birth to God, the Logos. We magnify you, the true Theotokos.
Λέγετος, ανοίξω το στόμα μου και πληρωθήσετε πνεύματος και λόγον ερέξω με τη Βασιλή Δημήτρη και οφθήσω με φετρός πανηγυρίζων και ασογηθόμενος ταύτης τα θαύματα.
I open my mouth and pray, the Spirit fill it like David said, to pour out a good word to the Queen and Mother of God. I will celebrate her feast with joy and gladness and sing to her merrily, lauding her miracles.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. O maiden and virgin pure, the great archangel saluted you. Rejoice, living book of Christ, of which Isaiah foretold that it would be sealed to all men by the Spirit. O vessel of joy, through you the curse on Eve shall be loosed.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. Rejoice, virgin bride of God. Through you was Adam restored to life, and Hades was put to death. O blameless one, rejoice. Since you bore the King, we say you are his palace, the fiery throne of the ruler of all, rejoice.
Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Rejoice, you have budded forth a holy Son, the unfading rose, the one whom the song has likened to a sweet apple tree. Ever virgin bride, rejoice, you are the fragrance, beloved by King of all, through you the world is saved.
Both now and ever into the ages of ages, amen. We cry out, rejoice to you who are the treasure of chastity. Through you we have risen from our fall, O Lady, rejoice. We believer sense the fragrance that you send forth, sweet lily and frankincense, costly anointing oil.
Τους ους υμνολόγους Θεοτόκε, ως όσα και αυτόν ως πηγή, διάσων συγκροτήσαντας πνευματικών στερεώσων και εν τη Θεία δόξη σου στεφάνον δόξης αξίωσον.
Establish your servants who extol you, O Mother of God, for they have formed a spiritual choir for you, the living and abundant font. And graciously in your divine glory give glorious crowns to them.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. Rejoice, blessed Virgin, you have born Christ, the wheat that came forth from land unplowed. The table symbolizes you, who held the Lord the bread of life. Rejoice, O never empty well of living water, O bride of God.
Most holy Theotokos, save us, for us the believers you have mothered, the unblemished bowl of Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. We therefore call you Heifer, and you rejoice. You are the mercy seat from which forgiveness has come to us.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Christ, the Son of Righteousness, has risen from you, Bride of God and Shining Dawn. Rejoice, for as the dwelling place of Him who is the Light of the world, you drove away the night of sin and darkness. Demons now fade away.
Both now and ever into the ages of ages. Amen. The east gate through which the Prince alone went, prefigured your body for the Lord, alone came forth from you. Rejoice, your Son has shattered Hades' gates. Rejoice, O all lauded and divine gateway of those who are being saved.
He who sits in holy glory, sits in holy glory on the throne of divinity, Jesus our Most High God, on a swift and light cloud has come to us, and by the might of his undefiled hand has saved those who cry to him. Glory to your power, O Christ.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. David saw you as the mountain in the spirit, fertile and rich, where God dwelt, O Lady. Therefore we salute you and sing rejoice, the golden jar with the honey-flavored manna of old points to you who held the sweetest heavenly bread of life.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. We extol you, blameless Virgin, mercy seat for the world, rejoice. Jacob's dreamt of ladder points to you, for God came to earth by you and elevates all to heaven by an act of grace. You are likewise a bridge that has conveyed us from death to life.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. You are higher than the heavens, O Immaculate Maid, rejoice. Painlessly you carried in your womb the Lord who founded the earth. We call you seashell, its dye was used in royal cloth, and your own blood dyed the divine flesh of the King of hosts.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. God the Word is the lawgiver who blots out the iniquities of all people freely, once the depth and heights of the love of Christ, surpassing knowledge. And now we sing rejoice to you, who gave birth to him, Lady, through you we were deified.
Look now and ever into the ages of ages, amen. crown of hope woven of glory is your Son who is Lord of hosts. So Isaiah said it, we say you have woven it for the world. To you, O Virgin, the fortress and defense of all, and protective wall and sacred refuge, we sing rejoice.
Amazed was the universe by your divine magnificence. You were perpetually virgin, carried the heavenly God of all in your womb, and gave birth to the eternal Son, who awards salvation to all who sing hymns of praise to you.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. Rejoice, Virgin Bride of God, you carried in your womb the way and the life, O Mother of the Savior. The world is saved from the flood of sin through you. Awe-inspiring tidings and good news. Rejoice, for the Master of all creation abode in you.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. Rejoice, mighty fortress of humanity, O spotless maid, holy place of glory, as the psalm says. Bright bridal chamber from which your Son came forth, as the Son of righteousness, rejoice. Joy of angels, aid for all who with faith pray to you, rejoice.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. Rejoice, fiery chariot of God the Logos, whom you bore. Paradise prefigured you, O Lady, for in its midst was the tree of life, now the Lord. The fruit of your womb is giving life to us who were subject once to corruption and Eden fate.
Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Enabled by the strength you give, we faithfully cry out, rejoice. Unhewn mountain from which came the stone cries, concerning you, city of the great King of all, we glorious things indeed declared in the Psalms and the prophecies. O immeasurable depth, depth, rejoice.
Both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. O Mother of God, rejoice. You are the oyster that produced Christ, the divine pearl of great value. You are the spacious, all-wondrous dwelling place of the Word of Virgin pure. Rejoice, we extol you every day, and you pray to the Lord for us.
In theon toft in kepondimon, telundes eortin ni theophrones tis theomitoros defte tas hieras crotis omen ton ex aftis tecthente theon doxazonde.
O godly-minded believers, come and celebrate this sacred and venerable feast, and thus extol the Theotokos, and clap our hands, and glorify our God, who was truly born of her.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. O bridal chamber of God the Word, we credit the theosis of all to you, O Virgin pure, rejoice. The prophets echoing prophecies fulfilled in you adorn what apostles then proclaimed.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. The fleece upon which alone the dew for Gideon dripped down once prefigured you, to whom we sing rejoice. From you, O Virgin, did Christ come forth as healing dew, extinguishing pagan passions all.
Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Behold, we greet you now, we sing rejoice, and we are tossed about on the stormy sea of life's adversities, and all the snares of our enemy become for us the port and the fair haven we desire.
Both now and ever into the ages of ages. Amen. O cause of joy, you inspire us to call you unconsumed burning bush and shining pillar of a cloud. Because the Lord was in you as well, you always guard the faithful who sing to you rejoice.
Godly minded, three did not adore created things in the Creator's stead, rather disdaining the threat of fire. They trampled it joyfully, and joyfully they sang, O supremely praised and most exalted Lord and God of the fathers, you are blessed.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. We salute you, rejoice. You bore the Son of Righteousness, and thus the mythical type of chariot applies to you, the testament of image of the vines and ripened grape. Point to you who brought forth the Lord, of whose blood now gladdens hearts of the faithful who extol you.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. In your womb you held the one who heals humanity. Rejoice, O Bride of God. Isaiah called you the rod of Jesse, for you brought forth the flower that is Christ, the unfading word. Rejoice, through you we too rejoice and inherit life, O Lady.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. Insufficient are all languages for poetry and hymns extolling you, for you, O Lady, were raised higher than the seraphim for bearing Christ the King. Now entreat him for us, who honor you to rescue us from disasters that befall us.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. From the ends of the earth, the faithful are extolling you, singing, O Virgin, rejoice. Isaiah called you a book, on which by the Father's finger was the word inscribed. Pray him earnestly to write your servants in the Lamb's Book of Life, O Theotokos.
Both now and ever into the ages of ages. Amen. We, your servants, pray, entreating you, and like Manasseh, bend the knee of our hearts. O pure one, lend us an ear and save us, for we are drowning in adversities. And preserve the church from schism and from heresy, O holy Theotokos.
Guiltless were those servants in the furnace. The Son of the Theotokos went and rescued them. He who was prefigured then, having been incarnate now, is gathering the whole wide world into its church to sing, O all your works of the Lord to all ages. Sing praises to the Lord and exalt him beyond measure.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. You welcomed into your womb the Logos. You held in your arms the one who holds all things. You, O Virgin, nurse the one who by his divine command gives food to all, O maiden pure. And now we sing to him, O all you works of the Lord to all ages. Sing praises to the Lord and exalt him beyond measure.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. The glorious mystery of your childbirth did Moses perceive within the burning bush. Servants of the Most High God, vividly prefigure this. For standing in the fiery furnace, they remained unburned, undefiled, undefiled, and all holy virgin. Therefore we sing praises to you all to all the ages.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. We who were left naked through deception now wear an imperishable robe through you who bore the immortal God, Holy Virgin, House of Life. And we who sat in darkness of our sins have seen the light, as once foretold by the prophet Isaiah. Therefore we sing praises of you to all the ages.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Through you who gave birth to life in person, were we who were dead in sin brought back to life. Through you, those who once were mute have become most eloquent. Through you are those afflicted by disease and cancer cured. Defeated are the hosts of the demons. Humanity is saved through your childbirth, O Virgin.
Both now and ever and to the ages of ages. Amen. You gave birth to Christ, the world's salvation. Through you has humanity been lifted up from the earth to heaven. Rejoice, O all blessed Virgin, rejoice. O mighty fortress and protection of the faithful who sing, O all you works of the Lord to all ages, sing praises to the Lord and exalt him beyond measure.
All you born on earth, with festival lamps in hand, in spirit leap for joy. And all you the heavenly angelic orders, join in and celebrate. And honoring the sacred feast of the Mother of God, sing the joyful salutation, O rejoice. Theotokos, all blessed ever Virgin pure.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. Rescue us, we pray, from foreign invasion and from every other scourge, that we might experience a as result of the multitude of sin committed by humanity, so that we faithful who share the divine and everlasting joy through you might salute you, O Virgin, and sing rejoice.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. We who are confirmed in faith and illumined through you, Lady, sing to you. Rejoice, O unsetting star. You brought the great sun into the world, rejoice. O pure one, you reopen Eden that was closed of old. Fiery pillar ushering humanity out of bondage to heavenly life, rejoice.
Most holy Theotokos, save us. In the house of God, let us stand with reverence as we sing with sacred joy. Queen of all the world, rejoice. Rejoice, O Mary, the Lady of us all. The only blameless and the fairest among women, rejoice. Living vessel that received the unemptied word, who like ointment was poured into you, rejoice.
Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, only perfect dove through whom brought forth the Lord of mercy as an olive branch. Ever Virgin Mary, rejoice. You are the boast of devout monastic saints. Rejoice, you are the glory of the holy martyrs. Rejoice, and the righteous pride themselves in knowing you. We the faithful have you as our rescuer.
Now and ever into the ages of ages. Amen. Pity us. us, O God, and spare your inheritance by overlooking now all of our iniquities. For this accepting the fervent prayers of her, who without sin gave birth to you on earth, O Christ our God, who in your great mercy willed to take on flesh, thus assuming the form that was not your own.
Shown by the Creator in showing himself unto us whom he had created, sprouting up upon this unseeded womb while preserving as it was inviolate, so that beholding the miracle we might extol her, exclaiming, rejoice, O flower of incorruptness, rejoice, O crown of laurel for continence, rejoice, for in you resurrection is typified. Rejoice, for angelical life you exemplified. Rejoice, fertile tree with luscious fruit, by which believers are sustained. Rejoice, foliaged tree beneath which are many sheltered in its shade. Rejoice, for you were pregnant with a guide for the errand. Rejoice, for of the freer of the captives, you are the parent. Rejoice, who built, plead till the just judge surrenders. Rejoice, forgiveness for many offenders. Rejoice, the vesture of those stripped of confidence. Rejoice, the tender love that conquers every longing. Kerenimphi. On seeing the strange childbirth, let us be estranged from the mundane, transporting our mind to heaven. For this purpose, the supernal God, as a humble human being, appeared down on earth, intending to attract unto the summit those who cry out to him, Alleluia.
Present below, completely and above, no wise absent was the incircumscribable Logos. For it was no migration through space, but divine condescension that had taken place, and childbirth from a God-possessed virgin who hears this that follows. Rejoice, the uncontainable God's container. Rejoice, the magnificent mystery's doorway. Rejoice for unbelievers, a doubtful story. Rejoice for the believers, the doubtless glory. Rejoice, all holy vehicle of him who rides the cherubim. Rejoice, exquisite domicile of him who mounts the seraphim. Rejoice, who integrate in yourself a contradiction. Rejoice, who incorporate both virginity and parturition. Rejoice, through whom the trespass was nullified. Rejoice, through whom was paradise opened wide. Rejoice, the opener to Christ's kingdom. Rejoice, the hope of eternal blessings. Kerenim fi anim fefter. Quite amazed by the great deed of your incarnation was the entire nature of angels. For once, the once inaccessible God, they beheld accessible to all as a man, with us together sojourning while thusly hearing from everyone, Alleluia.
Richly eloquent rhetors, we see speechless as fishes when they contemplate you, O Theotokos. For at a loss they are to explain how you manage childbirth and a virgin yet remain. But we, in marveling at the mystery, cry out with conviction. Rejoice, God's wisdom repository. Rejoice, his providence depository. Rejoice, who proved the philosophers wisdomless. Rejoice, who reproved the sophists as ridiculous. Rejoice, for the fierce debaters becoming fools lost their taste. Rejoice, for the creators of the myths have faded away. Rejoice, you who ran the webs of the Athenians. Rejoice, you fill the nets of the fishermen. Rejoice, who drag out of from the deep of ignorance. Rejoice, who illuminate many with cognizance. Rejoice, the barge for those seeking salvation. Rejoice, the far harbor for life's navigators. Kerenimfe, animfefte. Set on saving the cosmos, he who set all things in order came down to it of his own volition. And though being the shepherd as God, for us he appeared like us as a man, and having called his own like by like as God he hears. Alleluia.
Holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, forgive our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever into the ages of ages.
Amen. O planter of creation, Lord, to you does the entire world bring as an offering the God-bearing martyr saints, as being nature's first fruits. As their earnest entreaties keep your church in a state of profoundest peace, through the Theotokos, O Lord, abundantly merciful. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. O Christ our God, who at all times and at every hour, both in heaven and on earth, are worshipped and glorified, long suffering and plenteous in mercy and compassion, who love the just and show mercy to the sinners, who call all men to salvation, to the promise of blessings to come. Do you, the same Lord, receive our supplications at this present time and direct our lives according to your commandments. Sanctify our souls, purify our bodies, set our minds right, clear up our thoughts and deliver us from every sorrow, evil, and distress. Surround us with your holy angels that being guarded and guided by their presence, may we arrive at the unity of faith and the knowledge of your ineffable glory. For blessed are you unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Glory greater in honor is than the cherubim, and in glory greater beyond compare than the seraphim. You without corruption gave birth to God the Word, and are truly Theotokos. You do we magnify. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
May God have compassion on us and bless us. May his face shine upon us and have mercy on us.
Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Save us, all holy Theotokos. O spotless, unstained, incorruptible, undefiled, pure virgin, Lady Bride of God, who through your wondrous birth-giving united God the Word with mankind, and link the fallen nature of our human race with the heavenly, the only hope of the hopeless, and the help of the persecuted, the ready support of those who seek refuge in you, and the shelter of all the Christians. Do not despise me, the wretched sinner, who have defiled myself with shameful thoughts and words and deeds, and through negligence of thought have become slave to the pleasures of life. But as the mother of our compassionate God and a friend of man, have compassion on me, the sinner and prodigal, and accept this prayer from my impure lips. And using your motherly standing, entreat your Son and our Master and Lord to open unto me the depths of his loving goodness, and overlooking my innumerable faults, to return me to repentance and make me a worthy servant of his commandments. Stand by me forever in this life as a merciful and compassionate and good and lovingly warm protector and helper, by repulsing the assaults of the adversary and leading me toward salvation, and at the time of my death, by embracing my miserable soul and driving far away from it the dark faces of the evil demons, and at the awesome day of judgment, by redeeming me from eternal hell and proclaiming me an heir of the ineffable glory of your Son and our God. May I enjoy such fate, my Lady, most holy Theotokos, through your intercession and protection, through the grace and love for mankind of your only begotten Son, our Lord and God and Savior, Jesus Christ, to whom belong all glory, honor, and worship, together with his beginningless Father, and the all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever into the ages of ages. Amen.
And grant to us, Master, as we depart for sleep, rest of body and soul, and preserve us from the gloomy slumber of sin and from every dark and nocturnal pleasure. Arrest the drives of passion, extinguish the burning arrows of the evil one, which insidiously fly in our direction. Suppress the rebellions of our flesh, and calm our every earthly and material thought, and grant to us, O God, alert mind, prudent thinking, sober heart, light sleep free of any satanic fantasy. Awaken us at the time of prayer, rooted in your commandments, and having unbroken within us the remembrance of your ordinances. Grant that we may sing your glory through the night by praising and blessing and glorifying your honorable and majestic name, of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, into the ages of ages. Amen.
Most
most glorious ever-Virgin, blessed Theotokos, bring our prayer before your Son and our God, and entreat him through you to save our souls.
The Father is my hope, the Son is my refuge, the Holy Spirit is my shelter. Holy Trinity, glory to you.
O Mother of God, I have committed my every hope wholly unto you. Keep me under your shelter.
Glory. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Father, bless.
May Christ, our true God, through the intercessions of his all-pure and all-immaculate Holy Mother, the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and merciful and loves mankind. Let us pray for the peace of the world.
Kyrie eleison.
For the pious and orthodox Christians.
Kyrie eleison.
For our Archbishop Alexios.
Kyrie eleison.
For our nation.
Kyrie eleison.
For the armed forces.
Kyrie eleison.
For our absent fathers, brothers, and sisters.
Kyrie eleison.
For those who help us and those who serve us.
Kyrie eleison.
For those who hate us and those who love us.
Kyrie eleison.
For those who have asked us, the unworthy, to pray for them.
Kyrie eleison.
For the release of the captives.
Kyrie eleison.
For those who are traveling.
Kyrie eleison.
For those laid up with illnesses.
Kyrie eleison.
For those who, let us pray also for the abundance of the fruits of the earth.
Kyrie eleison.
And for all of our fathers and brethren departed this life, who lie here in peace, and the Orthodox everywhere.
May their memory be eternal.
Let us say for ourselves also, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Beautiful in your virginity, Archangel Gabriel admired your purity, which was resplendent and amazed, and said to you, Theotokos, as there is no accolade that can worthily honor you, I am at a loss for words to address you in awe am I. But I will say what I was commanded. Rejoice, favored maiden, full of grace.
Please be seated, and Father Michael will give a few words.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Good evening, everyone. Well, so You may or may not know, but I grew up in an Orthodox tradition which was very much influenced by the Russian kind of spiritual tradition. My father and mother became Orthodox when I was 2 years old, and I was baptized when I was two, and they had become Orthodox as a result of meeting this Russian monk who was from California, and they, along with many other people, including many of you probably knew him, Father Jacob Myers down in Atlanta of blessed memory. He was part of the same kind of group that my parents were part of when they all kind of became Orthodox at the same time. And so I grew up in that tradition, and there are some, I mean, it's one Orthodox church, whether you're Greek or Russian or Romanian or Serbian, but there are definitely some unique local, or Antiochian, but there are some unique local traditions, not only within each ethnicity, but even from church to church, from parish to parish. And one of the differences is that during Lent, in the Russian tradition, they do not do the beautiful supplication service to the Mother of God, the so-called hieritizmi, what we're doing this evening. Instead, it depends on each parish, but oftentimes they'll do pre-sanctified liturgy on Wednesday nights, and then another pre-sanctified on Friday nights. So it was different when I entered into the Greek Archdiocese and spent some time in Greece and experienced the beauty of the supplication service or the salutation service to the Mother of God. And I just wanted to reflect briefly on kind of my general impression of that as I experienced it kind of later on in life. I think we can all probably agree that Lent is a time of deep spiritual growth and beauty, but it's also oftentimes experienced as kind of being more somber, maybe even heavier, and certainly a time where we focus on our own repentance as Orthodox Christians leading up to Pascha. So there is this sense that it is a serious time. And of course, as anything in life, we can take things to extremes in one direction or another. Lent can be a beautiful counterbalance to our society's desire for seeking pleasure and only pleasure and just kind of being happy all the time. Not that it's a bad thing to be happy all the time, but sort of on a very superficial level, let's say. So Lent can kind of bring us a little bit deeper into ourselves, into the reality of life. But I think many of us would agree that it's easy to kind of go overboard with that even. So then if we do decide to go deeper into our own repentance during Lent, sometimes we can feel too weighed down by our own sinfulness, by our own sense of brokenness, and feel like Lent is just kind of depressing. So as I experienced the Friday night salutation services, one of the things that really struck me was the way in which Friday nights become almost an oasis of lightness in the midst of the sometimes heaviness of Lent. We don't wear our Lenten vestments. We wear kind of lighter blue vestments in honor of the Mother of God. The hymns are kind of more joyful and more beautiful. And in general, it doesn't have that kind of penitential tone that you would experience during the rest of Great Lent. So in that sense, it's a different ethos. And you could ask, does it fit? Does it fit during the Lenten season for us to kind of be wearing lighter vestments and to be kind of more lighter and joyful? As I was kind of thinking about this reflection, one of the moments in Scripture that came to mind specifically in relation to the Mother of God was the first time that Christ performed a public miracle, right? Which was at the wedding of Cana. And the reason why he performed this miracle was because, well, first of all, he was at a wedding, so it was a feast. It was something joyful. But something very sad happened at that feast, and that was that the family ran out of wine, which would have been a huge kind of cultural taboo in those days. And so the Mother of God, knowing who her son was, having experienced, you know, life with him for those 30 years prior, turned to him and said, you know, won't you do something for them? And he said something which we may or may not have caught, which is, you know, woman, my time has not yet come. What have you to do with me? My time has not yet come. Meaning, this would be, in a technical sense, a deviation from the plan of the will of God as Christ was being called to fulfill it in obedience to the Father. And yet, she turned to the servants and said, do what he tells you. So, in that sense, though it was a deviation, somehow, because of the relationship of Jesus and his mother, to his mother, and the depth of that relationship, he obeyed his mother. And somehow, paradoxically, deviated from the divine will of his father. Deviated, quote unquote. Nothing is a deviation in the work of Christ, but somehow it was this kind of change, right? And I think of that in relation to the supplication service, because again, I think there's something about the Mother of God that offers us or invites us to experience, even in the throes of the Lenten penitential ethos, which is beautiful, and there's nothing wrong with it, but even in the midst of that, when we approach the Mother of God, there's something that allows us to experience the lightness, a quality of lightness and a quality of joy, well before we experience the explosion of joy of Pascha. So I don't know if it's an accident, though it is a local tradition, you could say, or a particular tradition to the Greek church. And I'm not sure if do Antiochians also do supplication service on Friday nights. Okay, so though it is particular to these traditions and not done in other Orthodox churches, I think it fits. I think it fits within the Lenten somberness, insofar as the Mother of God, you know, in the seriousness of her son's obedience to the Father, was able to sort of bring his attention to something that in a sense wasn't necessary. I mean, it's not particularly necessary that he changed the water into wine at the wedding of Cana. It didn't have some sort of cosmic, you know, impact, at least that we can see. And yet it saved these poor people from bearing the social and cultural embarrassment of the moment. And so there's something sweet and beautiful about that as well. So I suppose the practical application for all of this, if we were to boil it down, is yes, it is good for us to delve more deeply into the penitential season of Great Lent. Yes, it is a blessing that God reveals to us in the midst of Great Lent, oftentimes our own imperfection, our own sinfulness, the ways in which we have exiled ourselves or become exiled from the will of God, like Adam and Eve being exiled outside of paradise. And all of those things are well and good. And yet somehow the Mother of God comes in these moments on Friday nights, reminding us not to take ourselves and the kind of direness of our sinfulness too seriously. Of course we're going to take it seriously. We're going to take it seriously. And yet there's some joy in the midst of it all as well. There's some joy in the midst. And never to lose sight of the joy of our faith, even when we're focusing on our imperfection and our sinfulness. Because that's, I think, what the Mother of God calls us to do. And when we turn to her, we receive that same comfort and consolation and joy as well. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
The prayers of our holy fathers, our Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us. Okay, we invite everyone to come forward and venerate the icon and have a blessed evening. And our next service will be tomorrow evening, our usual Vespers at 5 p.m. Have a blessed evening.